Have a seat. We're going to sing "All Day Long I've Been With Jesus and It's Been a Wonderful Day."
Take off your headband. We are going to pray. We're going to get started. Father, I thank you for this day. I thank you for the kids you sent our way. Father, I pray that you work in our hearts. May we have a lot of fun. May we get what you have for us. And I thank you for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name, we ask these things. Amen. We are going to play a special game. Snake game. Krista, and I need Miss Elizabeth. Is she in here? Mr. Weir will work. I don't know. Okay, we're going to stretch out ropes here. And what we have is we are going to make a snake. How many like snakes? I don't like snakes. The only snake I like is a dead snake. The other day, I was coming home from church, and I was running across my parking lot, and I almost stepped on a snake. And it almost got me. I mean, I do not like snakes at all. So what we're going to do is we're going to stretch out these ropes, and in this bucket is, you can stretch that out, Miss Joy, that the needle needs to be on that side. We have a bunch of pool noodles. At the bottom of this bucket is a snake head. So what we gotta do is 4th through 6th grade fellas and 4th through 6th grade ladies, what you're gonna do, I need you to sit down, We're going to file out that way. Just listen. We're gonna both file out towards the wall. We're gonna come in, and what we have to do is it's a speed game. We have to make the snake as fast as we can. On the end of this rope is a little needle. And all we have to do is slide that over, and we have to run it down all the way to the end where Miss Krista's standing. All right? And then the last one is the snake head. Your teacher has to put on the snake head.
Oh.
Okay? So what we're going to do is we're going to file out, run it down, and then you want to go back to your seat, and then you may have to run twice. So be ready, okay? The only rule I have is you cannot have the same color next to each other. There's three colors in the bucket. You cannot have the same color next to each other. Make sense? Alright, 4th through 6th grade ladies, Miss Samantha, you can organize them. You need to be lined up by your bucket. 4th through 6th grade fellas, Mr. Lincoln can organize you. You need to be lined up by your bucket. And the snake head goes on last. Teacher has to do that. Do not have the same color beside each other. I think we can do this. 1st and 3rd grade fellas and ladies, you better be watching. You're doing it next. Alright? Do we got it? Do we understand? Line up. Get organized. Let me know when you're ready. Make sense. Are we ready? Are we ready, Mr. Layman? Are we ready, Mrs. Samantha? Make sure you go back to your seat. Who's better, the boys or the girls? On your mark. Get set and go! Run, 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 run,
Saved and you know it, then you're face, so we're gonna be showing. If you're saved and you know it, then you're all great.
Joe, we are ready.
All right, thank you, Mr. Jason. This means you go ahead and say it if it can be said. Okay. We have popsicles. How many like popsicles? Very good. Thank you very much. All right, what we have is we're going to sing that song if we have time for it. But first, we're going to have a popsicle. I was looking for those who were singing, and
I absolutely turned myself on.
So I need Brooklyn, and I need Jay. You said your name was Jay in Brooklyn. Okay, we're going to sing the popsicle. How many things a girl can eat more than a guy at Master? Okay.
Yeah.
I know, guy. How many things can a guy can eat faster than a girl? Okay. Hey, Jay, right here. Right here. Go ahead and have that thing empty and turned upside down. Am I off?
Very good. Am I on now? Thank you. Thank you. On your mark. Get set. Are you ready, Brooklyn? Okay, get it in your mouth or something. On your mark. Get set. Cheer for your team. Go! Go, 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 go.
Fellas,
sing that for mom and dad? Think we can show them how we can sing? All right, we're going to sing it one more time, and then we have to get rolling, all right? So everyone together, ready?
So
Father, I pray that you work in the hearts of those that are in the salvation group. May they understand, Father, may we have genuine salvations tonight. Please work in our hearts. Please stir us to revival. And I thank you for what you're going to do. In Jesus' name, we ask these things. Amen. How many remember what we learned on Monday? Anybody remember what we learned on Monday? We learned on Monday how to be qualified for the Christian race. Anybody remember? Yes, sir, Mr. Jason.
We asked Jesus to take us to heaven.
We accept Christ's gift of heaven. Now, let me explain that a little bit for the new kids here today. All right? We're all... have done bad. How many's done bad in here? I'm going to raise my hand like 10 times.
Because I've done lots of bad, okay?
We've all sinned. The Bible calls the bad things we do sin. Now, how many have ever disobeyed mom and dad? You can ask my mom. I've disobeyed her before. Not good news. Because when I disobey, what happens? I get in trouble. It's bad news, okay? When we disobey God, I need you to listen up here. Catalina Josephina. I need you up here, okay? All right, when we disobey God, it's bad. All right, there's a punishment. God says we have to die and we have to go to hell. All right, how we talked about it on Monday night is we all have sin. And God says for the wages of sin is what?
Death.
God says we all have to die. And I won't go into detail, but God says when we die, we have to go to hell. What's in hell? Fire. The devil's going to be in hell. Good job, James. Okay, so we all have sin. The Bible says when we die, we have to go to hell. How many want to go to hell?
No.
Okay. God didn't want us to go to hell either. Okay? So if we have an extra lady worker, we could use you up on the front. Okay? So God didn't want us to go to hell, so He sent God. He came in a body like ours and came down to earth. And He was a boy just like DJ. Did you know God became a boy just like you? And He lived for 33 years, and He didn't sin. He didn't do wrong. So did He have to die and go to hell? No, He didn't have to die and go to hell. What He did is He died on the cross, and He paid for our sin. So we all have what? Sin. We all have what?
Sin.
Very good. Where do we have to go to pay for our sin?
Hell.
We have to go to hell. God doesn't want that. So Jesus died on the cross to pay for our sin. So we all have sin. Has to be paid for. God is offering a gift. The Bible says the gift of God is eternal life. God wants to give you a gift of heaven. So what we have is, we have sin. We can say, God, I don't want your gift. I want to go to hell. Or we can say, God, you want to give me heaven? I want to take heaven. The Bible says, for whosoever shall what?
Call.
For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. You can know you're going to heaven if you accept God's gift. Now, if you have a question on that, I want you to ask one of the workers sitting beside you or your teacher, okay? Now, so, how do you qualify for the Christian race? When you run a marathon, you have to be so old, all right? There was a 100-year-old man in Canada that ran a marathon and finished.
Wow.
100 years old. He just did it like 2 years ago. Can you imagine that?
That's old.
Okay? But you have to be so old. Lillian, you couldn't run a marathon. They wouldn't let you. You probably could over a long time, but they wouldn't let you. You have to be so old. How do you qualify for the Christian marathon? You have to accept the gift of God. Okay? We just talked about that. Now, we talked about Paul yesterday. Remember, Paul was a bad guy. He put people that believed in Jesus in jail, didn't he? Remember that? Okay? And then he even had them put to death. You remember that? But then he accepted God's gift of heaven. And now he's going to heaven. And then he gives us pointers. He says he puts his body under subjection. He doesn't. Remember the guys yesterday, Frank, Ned, and Tiny? They wanted to eat that ice cream, didn't they? They wanted those Skittles. I mean, there's a lot of good food. But they said no, because we can't do that. They had to prepare. So, how do you prepare for the Christian race? You don't prepare to run a marathon, run a race, by eating a bunch of junk food, do you? You don't prepare for the Christian marathon by feeding your flesh. Let's look at this. How do we prepare for the Christian marathon? You get what?
Get baptized!
You talked about the yesterday. What do? Get
baptized.
We talked about that yesterday. We're baptizing tomorrow. Guess what? We already have 4 kids that parents gave permission to sign up.
Wow. 4 kids.
How many say, I ask, accept the God's gift of heaven, and I want to get baptized? Is that you? Raise your hand. You got to talk to mom. You got to talk to dad, okay? 4 other kids will get baptized tomorrow night. You can too, okay? Can we shut the doors in back, Kristen? Thank you. Get baptized. The second thing is, read your Bible and what?
Pray.
We all have a Bible. If you don't, your sibling does. Read your Bible and pray. Guess what? What is praying? Praying is talking to God. Now, a lot of you, how many have a friend here tonight? You're sitting by a friend?
Yeah, we all have friends, okay?
And we talk to our friends. Blair brought her friend tonight. That's awesome, okay? We all have friends. We talk to friends. Guess what? We can talk to God the same way. I told you last night, but I went to the end room today, and I got on my knees, and I talked to God. I said, God, I said, you stir adults to revival. You make adults want to do what's right. And then you make teenagers want to do what's right. I said, God, why can't you make these kids want to do what's right? I said, God, please stir us to revival. I prayed for you today. I talked to God just like I talked to you. I came and saw y'all. Some of y'all do crafts today, all right? I said, how you doing? How's it going? What are you doing? All right, I can talk to God the same way. I can tell God about anything. I can ask him about anything. Does that make sense? Praying is talking to God. Third thing is, come to what? Come
church.
To church. All right, this is church. You're in church tonight. I'm proud of you. God says, come to church. Every Sunday, you can come to this church with a bunch of other kids and learn about God. That's what God wants us to do. So how do we prepare for the Christian race? We get
baptized.
Very good. We read our
Bible.
And we
pray.
And then we come to
church.
Very, very good. Okay. So, Ned, Frank, and Tiny, they want to run a marathon, don't they?
Yeah.
Do you remember the 2 bad guys trying to get them to eat all that junk food?
Yeah.
Did they eat the junk food?
No.
Okay, so today, the bad guys try to detour Frank, Ned, and Tiny.
Yeah.
It almost worked, didn't it?
Yeah.
They thought about it, but they didn't get detoured. I want you to see this. How do you prepare for the Christian marathon to get baptized? Don't get detoured. Some of you, is anyone afraid of water? Yeah. You know what? Miss Brooke back here was afraid of water for a long time, but guess what? If I remember right, Miss Brooke, you got baptized, didn't you? She was afraid of water, but guess what she did? She said, I'm in a Christian marathon. Maybe she didn't think of this, but she was in a Christian marathon, and she did not want to get to her. Miss Brooke, wave your hand at us. She's a kid just like all of y'all. Right back here. Over here. See that? Y'all looking around. Miss Brooke, wave again. Okay. She's a kid just like us, okay? She was afraid of water. If you're afraid of water, don't get detoured. Frank, Ned, and Tiny, they could have got detoured and gone the wrong way. Would have been bad news for the race, wouldn't it? You're in a Christian race if you accepted God's gift. And don't get detoured. God says, get baptized. So what we want to do is we want to talk to mom and dad and see if we can get you baptized. Make sense? Good? Okay, next one. Read your Bible and pray every day. Now, it might get tough. I get up at 6 o'clock every morning. And like I told you yesterday, I eat breakfast, and then I go to my room, and I read my Bible and pray. I'm tired sometimes. I'm really tired. Like, I'm going in and out. Ever done that? Like, doing your homework, and you go to sleep, and you wake up, and you go to sleep, and wake up. Ever done that? I've done that lots, okay? So, when you read your Bible and pray, you might be sleepy, okay? But do it anyway. Don't get detoured. Satan's trying to stop you. Second thing, you might not feel like it. I don't always feel like praying. Guess what? And Brother Joe's not called that spiritual. You might look like that, but it's not. You may not always feel like it, but do it anyway. Satan is trying to stop your race. Remember that. Remember that whenever you're reading your Bible, you say, I don't feel like reading my Bible. Remember the 2 bad guys up here trying to get Frank, Ned, and Tiny out that door when they should have gone that way. Did they go that way?
Yeah.
So should you. You should read your Bible and pray every day. Next one. Oh, we already did that. Oh, we already did that. Oh, we already did that. Come to church. Mom and dad might not bring you. Okay? What we want is we want mom and dad to bring you to church. But if they can't bring you to church or won't bring you to church, we want to pick you up. Okay?
Right.
So you go home and on Saturday you say, Mom and Dad, can you take me to church tomorrow? It starts at 9:30. I want to be there because I'm supposed to be there. And what if they say no, Sophia? Say, can we call the church and have someone pick me up? They said they'd pick me up.
Because we can pick you up. Okay? We'd love to.
You get picked up, Kylie, don't you? Kylie, wave at us. Come on, Kylie. There you go. Kylie gets picked up for church every Sunday. But you think you can bring mom and dad, Kylie? Think they can come?
Let's beg them, okay? So, mom and dad might not bring you. We'll pick you up. Beg them to bring you, though, okay? So Satan's trying to get you to go the other way. Don't miss church. Don't miss church, okay? You might be bored. Sometimes I come to church. I remember up here, I was sitting up here with Catalina and Josephina Hart, and I was probably like the first through third grade, okay? I was up here. And how many know Mr. Ben? You know Mr. Ben? I was up here with Mr. Ben, and we were both bored still. So guess what we did? And then, I don't know, we probably wrestled or something. Guess what? I got in trouble when I got home that day. It was bad news, okay? I was bored, but guess what? I didn't miss church. I came to church anyways. Make sense? Good? Don't let Satan beat you, okay? So God says, how do we prepare for the Christian race? First thing is we get
baptized.
If you're afraid of water, don't let it stop you, okay? Let's get that. Good job, DJ. So we have a yellow form. We want mom and dad to sign, and we can baptize you tomorrow night. Read your Bible and pray. How many have a Bible? You have a Bible? You can read it, all right? And if you don't know how to read, have mom or dad or older brother, older sister read it to you, okay? You can read the Bible and you can pray. Come to church. We'll pick you up. Try to have mom bring you. Make sense?
Yes,
sir. I think that's it. Oh, don't be too toured. Don't stop your race. If you accepted God's gift of heaven, if you're going to heaven, you're in a Christian race. Don't stop your race, okay? One last thing. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. How many have read that up there on the green flyer? Have you all read that up there? Some smart ones. It's there on the screen too. It's not a sprint, it's a marathon. What does that mean? How many know what a sprint is? It's like running from here to the black door. All right, it's a short run. But a marathon is running from here to your house. It's a long ways away, isn't it? So the Christian race is not like, go to church for 2 weeks. No, it's go to church every Sunday. Every Sunday. Every Sunday. Read your Bible every day. Every day. Every day. Got it? Good? That is it. What I have here is we're going to pray, and then we're going to quote our verses, okay? So let's bow our heads, and we're going to pray. Father, I pray that you help us today. Satan wants to detour us. He wants us to get off track and Father, fail in the Christian race, the marathon. I pray that we win it. Father, we follow Paul's advice. And Lord, you help us to be in church, get baptized if we can. Father, to read our Bible and pray every day. Thank you for what you're going to do. Thank you for what you have done already. In Jesus' name, we ask these things. Amen. All right. I really like that 4th through 6th grade girls stand up. Romans 10:13, your song was awesome. Do y'all remember that? Romans 10:13? Can we sing it? Go ahead. Whenever your workers... Do you have a worker? You don't have a... Oh, Mrs. Wiki. Thank you. Mrs. Wiki's going to lead you. All right. Romans 10:13. When you're ready, Mrs. Wiki.
Okay, what's the reference, girls?
Whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Very good. Thank you, ladies. You can sit down. How many know that verse? Romans 10:13. You're working on it. Good. If you know it, I want you to stand up. You know what? I want you to stand up. Tomorrow, mom and dad is going to be here, and I want you to be able to say it. Make them proud, okay? Make them think you know it. All right? So ready? We're going to say it together. We're going to say Romans 10:13. We're going to say the verse, and we're going to say Romans 10:13. Ready?
Romans 10:13. For whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. Romans 10:13.
You got it down. We're going to say it one more time. Ready?
Romans 10:13, for whosoever shall call upon the name of the Lord shall be saved.
Very good. You can sit down. Y'all have been memorizing at least the first through sixth grade. You've been memorizing John 3:16. How many know John 3:16? All the smart ones. All right. If you know John 3:16, I want you to stand up. We're going to say it, not sing it tonight. All right, ladies? Say it, not sing it. John 3:16. Ready?
John 3:16. For God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten Son, that whosoever believeth in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. John 3:16.
Good job. You can sit down. How many think, you know, I can quote that for mom and dad tomorrow when mom and dad are here? You think we're going to do that? All right, we're going to all stand up and say it together tomorrow night when mom and dad are here, so make sure you can do that, okay?
to work on that verse. Let's see, so we did our verses. Now, Brother Caleb, do we have paperwork? Awesome. Brother Caleb has points for me. How many want to know how many points your team class has?
Yeah!
Yes! Okay, day three. Day three. Wow. Wow. This is amazing. Okay. Four and fives, can you stand up?
Four and fives.
Now, we have the four and fives. We have the first through third boys and girls, and then fourth through sixth boys and girls. Let's see who has the which team has the most. Four and fives. Get this. You have 1,005,000 points. Whoa. Give yourself a hand. 1,005,000 points. Sit down. Okay, first through third girls, you can stand up. Let's see how many points you have. Girls, you have 1,030,000 points. Good job, girls. All right, first through third boys, stand up. All right, ready? First through third boys, you have 970,000 points.
Wow.
Good job. All right, try to catch up. Let's see, fourth through sixth girls, you can stand up. This is amazing. Girls, you have 1,360,000 points.
Wow.
Give yourself a hand. All right, you can sit down, fourth through sixth boys.
No!
Let's do this, guys. Fourth through sixth boys, you have 585,000 points. Oh. Give yourself a hand. Here we go. Tomorrow is the last night. Guess what that means? Tomorrow is the only day that counts plus this, okay? So tomorrow, what do you do for points? You bring your headband, okay? Bring your headband back. If you have a little booklet, bring that back. If you can bring a visitor, bring a visitor. That's 25,000 points. Bring your Bible and quote your verse. Did I get everything? I think I did. Do those things and you will help your team win. Tomorrow is the last night for points. Do we have any other names, Caleb? No names? Okay, so let's see. Announce score, and then tomorrow night, I want you to listen. Caleb, no names? Okay, this is what we got. I need you to listen up and we're going to dismiss. We have cookies tonight.
Homemade cookies. Oh, I love cookies.
Okay, tomorrow night, we're calling it family night, okay? If you need to get baptized, I want you to talk to your mom and dad about getting baptized. We're going to have a lot of mom and dads back here tonight, tomorrow night, and we're going to show them what we learned this week, okay? When you go to class, they're going to have class in here, and we're going to have a lot of fun, okay? But we're going to show them tomorrow night what we learned. Can we do that?
Yeah.
We're going to quote the verse. We're going to sing the song. We're going to have a lot of fun tomorrow night. And hopefully, if mom and dad haven't accepted God's gift of heaven tomorrow night, pray that they will, okay? You can start praying for mom and dad. All right, can we do that?
Yeah.
Very good. All right, we're going to see you tomorrow night. I need everyone with the number one on their hand to stand up.